So, we would like to talk about other operations if we are clear with this. We have another operation we call the theoretic difference. It may also be new to you, but we need to learn this for our own good. The theoretic difference, and it is written as A minus B, or we can also write it as A backslash B. So if A and B are the sets that we are using, when you see this operation A minus B or A backslash B, we call it the theoretic difference of what set A and B. And what does this mean when we say theoretic difference? Assuming we have a member or an element B in these two sets, let's say X. What it simply means is that that element can be found in A, and at that same time, that element cannot be found in what? The set B. Or in other words, when we have sets A and B, the theoretic difference is all the elements that can be found in A but cannot be found in what set B. That's what it means. Let's take an example to clarify that. Assuming we have set A to be the set of 1, 2, 3, and 4, and set B has the elements 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we want to find the theoretic difference here. That is A minus B. Or we can also write it as what? A backslash B. Any one of them you want to use is accepted. So taking A minus B, we said elements that are in A and are not in what? B. First, we need to locate elements that are in A and B. We can find out that 3 and 4 are common to both sets, but we want the one that exists in A but does not exist in what? B. It is 1 and 2 that exist in A but does not what? Exist in B. So our theoretic difference here is the elements 1 and 2, because they exist in only A but not what? In B. So that's all about theoretic difference. Now, last but not least, we are going to talk about the symmetric difference, which is also new, but we will learn it for our own benefit. The symmetric difference of two sets, let's say A and B. The symmetric difference between two sets A and B can be denoted as A plus with a circle around it and B. One may ask, what does this operation stand for, or what does it mean? Simply, we want the elements that are in set A. So the element X belongs to set A, or that element will belong to set B. And at the same time, that element cannot belong to A and B at the same time. Going over, the elements that fall under symmetric difference of A and B are the elements, let's say X. That element can be found in A only or in B only, and shouldn't appear in both A and B at the same time. So taking that same example, A as 1, 2, 3, 4, B as 3, 4, 5, and 6. Our theoretic difference was 1 and 2, but let's find out our symmetric difference will be this time, taking the definition in consideration. Now we want elements that appear in A only. We can see that only 1 and 2 appear in A only, so we place them down. We also want elements that appear in B only. Elements that appear in B only are 5 and 6. 5 and 6. And we are ending our sentence because we don't need elements that are equal or exist in both A and B. You can see that 3 and 4, 3 and 4 are equal to A and B or are common. So we exempt them from our set, and this is what the symmetric difference between two sets means. And also, lastly, we talk about the complement of a set. Assuming you have a set A, its complement can be written as A with a stroke up there. Also, we can use A with a subscript C, sorry, superscript C, or we can also write an A with what, a bar on top of it. Any way you choose to write it is accepted. Or assuming we have A intersection B, you want its complement, we can write it as A intersection B or complement or A intersection B or bar. Or we can also write it in this format. Any format you want to use is accepted. Now, we would like to end today's tutorials here, but in our next tutorial, we would like to have an in-depth understanding for complement like we did for intersection and what? Union. So to meet again, say goodbye.